Thank the maker, Star Wars Battlefront has gotten a new map and mission. The February update for the game introduces the Twilight on Hoth level along with the Survival in the Ice Caves mission. Cool stuff indeed! Now there are a ton of other tweaks for Star Wars Battlefront coming with the update too, such as an increase in damage for primary weapons against air vehicles, but none of the changes include adding R2-D2 as a playable hero. He booped a pretty sad boop after hearing the news, just so you know. Over 6.4 million people spent their weekend playing the Division Open Beta. Ubisoft is obviously very pleased with the high participation, claiming it's the biggest beta for a new franchise on Xbox One and PlayStation 4. Now, how many people went rogue with their early time in the Division? About 50%, which is a surprise to me. I expected more miscreants, but good to know there's millions of people out there that I could stab in the back in the Division. Don't let my chipper demeanor mislead you. I'll do terrible things for loot. If you pre-order Doom on Xbox One, you will receive the original Doom and Doom 2 for free as backward-compatible titles. Yep, Bethesda believes triple the Doom, triple the gory fun. I don't know about you, but I'm loving this bonus for upcoming games on Xbox One, and I can only hope that EA offers a very similar proposal with Mass Effect Andromeda. Come on, EA, you can do it. UFC superstar Ronda Rousey would space jump at the chance to star in a Metroid movie as the iconic Samus Aran. She recently chatted with GameSpot saying, "I've always wanted to be Samus. That would be badass. I hope they make a movie out of that. First off, I just want to throw my name into the hat to play Samus Aran. And next, I'm honestly just hoping for another Metroid game starring Samus at this point since it's been almost 6 years now." That's your Daily Fix for February 23rd. I'm Naomi Kyle, and remember, you can get your fix anytime online at IGN.